Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. says it's time to come clean on who ordered the pull out of Philippine ships during the 2012 Scarborough Shoal standoff with China. Loxin says the story keeps changing, adding the United States could not have ordered the Philippines because surrender is not an option in the Mutual Defense Treaty. He also says no power could make Manila back down, adding the 2016 arbitral award that invalidated China's sweeping claims falls for short of restoring what Manila lost. Former DFA Secretary Albert Del Rosario previously said it was China who breached the agreement brokered by the United States to withdraw all ships on both sides by a certain hour. In other news, bickering continues between President Duterte and former government officials on the maritime dispute with China. Duterte insists it was former Foreign Affairs Chief Albert Del Rosario's fault China was able to take over areas in the West Philippine Sea. The chief executive adds Del Rosario should be held liable for his actions.
Ikaw, Alberto, bakit mo inaatras? Kaninong permission ka naghingi? Ngayon kung wala kang maibigay, huwag mong ibigay sa akin yung kasalanan mo. Naghahanap kayo ng libre. Alam ninyo, one day, you will be tasked to answer for that. Yung pag-order ninyo, dapat imbestigahin ka. And if I don't know what I will be the history of this country. Because if I were a leader anymore, I will execute you by hanging.
Duterte also slammed former Supreme Court Senior Associate Justice Antonio Carpio. That's after the retired magistrate said Duterte may have committed grand estafa for denying making promises on the West Philippine Sea during the 2016 presidential campaign. President Duterte previously said the Philippines should be thankful for China's help amid the pandemic, but he insists China's generosity did not come with any commitment.
I never asked anything. I was asking friendship. That was all. Tapos, one after the other, sabi ni Xi Jinping, ito, bigay ko, ganun. So, salamat. Salamat kung meron. Kung wala, salamat rin. Supreme Court Justice, pareho man tayo abogado. Gusto mo, magdebate tayo. Madalawa, tatlong tanong lang ako. Sino ang nagpa-retreat? At anong ginawa ninyo after sa retreat?
Challenge accepted. Former Supreme Court Associate Justice Antonio Carpio says he will gladly take on Duterte's challenge for a debate. He leaves it up to the president where and when it will take place. Carpio, however, has a challenge of his own against the chief executive. The former magistrate wants Duterte to honor his word that he will resign if he can prove he had nothing to do with the withdrawal of Filipino ships in the West Philippine Sea. While Philippine officials bicker, some 200 ships are still moored in the West Philippine Sea. That's according to Liz Durr, co-founder and CEO of Simularity, a geospatial intelligence firm. She did not specify where the vessels originated, but Durr said the ships were similar to those spotted in Julian Felipe Reef, which were from China.
We've been monitoring the disputed areas of the South China Sea since October. They've been there longer than that. We've got some counts of ships near Titu Reef, near Pagasa Island, that go back several years. Almost all of them are moored. They don't move. You can see the wake in a satellite image if a ship is moving, and almost all of these ships are not moving, so they're moored in one place, just like they were at Whitsun Reef. We did see only one ship fishing at Whitsun Reef in March. Today, we see about seven ships fishing with their nets out near Hughes Reef.
The Philippine Coast Guard continues to deploy its ships and air assets over the West Philippine Sea. Just recently, it turned away seven Chinese vessels in Sabina Shoal.
yung ating mga eroplano, nagdi-deploy din po kami, nag-alternate po kasama po ng eroplano po ng Navy tsaka po ng Philippine Air Force. May mga schedule kami na sinusunod dyan.